We must also realize that the problems of racial injustice and economic injustice cannot be solved without a radical redistribution of political and economic power.
We're here, we're a new, unsettling force for liberation, and we got nothing to lose but our chains, and we got nothing to lose but our chains.
We have to deal with our world economy and systemic racism and systemic poverty and ecological devastation. And finally, we have to deal with the moral narrative.
And we won't be silent anymore. And we won't be silent anymore.
Did you know we have fewer voting rights today than we did 50 years ago? Did you know that 23 states have passed racist voter suppression laws since 2010? Did you know that it is over 1,800 days since the Supreme Court gutted the Voting Rights Act? That at least 17 states have voter suppression that has targeted Native American and/or Alaskan Native voters? That there are 6 million people whose right to vote has been taken away from them?
We demand an end to military aggression and warmongering.
Yes.
We demand a stop to the privatization of the military budget and any increase in military spending. We demand the demilitarization of our communities on the border and in the interior.
Remind the people in the legislature what Isaiah said 2,600 years ago. Woe unto those who legislate evil and rob the poor of their right and make women and children their prey. As long as the poor are being robbed, we're here. As long as the women are being hurt, we're here. As long as the children are being hurt, we're here. And we're not going anywhere.
Get ready.
Get ready for the revolution.
What you say?